Hi, I'm Michael Chesley Johnson. As you probably are aware, there are many different kinds of paint boxes out there in the world today for the oil painter and pastel painter. I have many of them. I've collected them over the last decade plus, and I've got so many in closets and other storage spaces, I don't know what to do with them all. But you know, they each serve their own purpose. Some days I like this one, some days I like another one. But what I'd like to do right now is go over some of the different ones I have. I pulled out a whole bunch of them from my closet here, and they're all a little different, and they all do different things. This is the 9x12 Gorilla Painter box from Gorilla Painter. It's got a couple of snaps in the front, and then a knob back here to release the lid. And then what you have in the lid is room for up to four 9x12s, or two stretched canvases of the same size. You can also get a series of nested adapters that you can insert in the lid that will handle 4x6, 5x7, and 8x10. If you want to paint a lot larger, there's even another adapter you can get. It has a little mask that raises up like this that you can then adjust to fit up to maybe a 12x16 inside the box, so it gives it a lot of flexibility. Inside the box itself, you've got the palette. You can see how clean mine is. And underneath that, you have a little brush tray for holding brushes, plus several compartments for paints, brushes, and whatever else you might happen to need in the field. All in all, it's a very compact box that you can fit on a tripod, or you can put it on a picnic table if you want, even work in your lap. The 9x12 Gorilla Painter box, a true pochade box that holds brushes, paints, everything. Gorilla Painter makes a series of these same boxes in different sizes. This is the 6x8 thumb box by Gorilla Painter, so-called thumb box because it has a small hole in the bottom where you can put your thumb in and support the box when you're painting if you'd like. I find it a little heavy to support on my arm with my thumb, but it also has a tripod mount in the bottom that's standard. This one opens up the same way as the other one. We'll snap there, little knob here, opens up. And then you have your space for four 6x8s inside. And like the 9x12, it also has a palette and plenty of room down below for brushes, paints, and whatnot. The brushes, of course, would need to be short-handled ones, or you can take your long brushes and cut them down to fit inside the box if you really want to travel compactly. All in all, it's a good little box for doing small sketches when you're in the field, or little studies for larger paintings. This is another Gorilla Painter box. It's just like the other two I showed you, only it's a lot bigger. This is the 12x16. Here's another pochade box. This one is called the Art Box from Travel Painter. And basically it's a very lightweight one that you can not have to use a tripod with. You can just use it in your lap, or you can even, using the strap, balance it right on your belly or your chest as you're standing and painting. Inside, it's got four, two 6x6 panels, and then it has a little palette. And underneath the palette, you have room for storing paints and other stuff. So it's very basic, but very lightweight. I don't believe this box is made anymore, but I have it in my collection. Basically, it's a Bitterroot light model, a prototype, I think, made by Wind River. And what's kind of neat about it is it's not just a 9x12 canvas carrier, but also a 12x16 when you use this attached piece here. So you can just remove it with this strap if you don't want to use it. And it's attached like that. It's held together by magnets. And voila, you've got yourself a 9x12 box. Everything here is fastened by magnets, so you don't have any screws to deal with or nuts and bolts. This opens like this to reveal the 9x12 wet panel carrier. Inside the lid, it has these small screws that are on springs that function as wet panel, panel holders when you're painting. Then you have the wooden palette that you access like this, you have to move this way. And inside that, you have a compartment for your paints and whatnot. They also have this palette extension, which fits like this with little springs. Sometimes a little hard to get on because it's made that way so it doesn't come off. Then you have a little extra area for putting brushes and paints and so forth. This is an old-fashioned paint box. You can probably still buy these in hobby stores, but basically it's just a wooden box with a handle. It's got a lid that can hold 12 by 16 paintings. It has a palette and a room for all your paints and stuff. Again, you'd work with your lap, or you'd work on a picnic table, but there's no tripod mount for it, and you probably wouldn't want to mount it on a tripod. This is the Easeal Classic. It's not a true pochade box. It doesn't have room for wet panels, doesn't have room for brushes and paints. But what it is basically a panel holder like this. It has a little mast that you can raise and lower. It's on a spring to accommodate different sizes of panels. This bracket also goes up and down. And then it has a glass palette. I put the glass in, originally just a wood palette. It has a wide mixing area and also holes drilled for brushes. This is another Easeal box. This one's oriented a little differently. Rather than being wide this way, it's tall. So when you open it up, you get a taller thing rather than having one that's wider. Just a different orientation for those who prefer that. Like the other box, it has the two nuts on it for loosening the lid. It also has a little screw here for loosening this mast, which you can raise and lower to whatever height you wish, and also a metal plate here to put your panel on. It also has a fairly big mixing area. This has got a glass palette that I installed. I like working in glass. Again, like the other box, it's basically just a palette and panel holder. There's no room for storing brushes and wet canvases. This is the Open Box N pochade box. For many years, it was the standard for professional plein air painters. Other than a French easel, this is like the best thing you could get. It's got a very narrow profile, and basically it's just a palette and panel holder. There are other accessories you can get that will hold wet panels and brushes and whatnot, but this is the core of the system. Basically, it's just a wooden palette, and it also has the panel holder with these adjustable brackets that allow you to use different size panels. You go quite far. And then on the lid, it has these little brackets that can be adjusted, or added, rather, through these screws that are on the bottom of the box. And what this does, it just basically expands your working area, so you can have more space for painting, more space for brushes and whatnot. This unit is similar to the ones that are just basically palette and panel holder. It's not a pochade box like the others that can hold brushes and paint tubes and so forth. Basically, it's just a palette and panel holder. But it's a little different in that the panel holder is detached from the palette. So this is the palette holder, panel holder. This is for the Day Tripper model of the Prolific Painter easel setup. You have these little brackets here that hold your panel. And these are adjustable through these little knobs. This attaches to the top of your tripod head with a quick release plate. So this can keep your panel at eye level. The other boxes will tend to not do that, so it's a little harder to keep it at eye level. The rest of the system is the palette. It basically has two wings that open like that. It has little brackets that open up and attach to your tripod legs. Basically, it just holds by gravity on your tripod legs. And then I've selected to get the one that has a plexiglass palette. It's been used, as you can see. And these wings are nice because you can put other paints out there or brushes and so forth. This last box is similar to the Day Tripper from Prolific Painter. It's called On Plein Air Pro. And basically it's the same idea. It's got a mast for holding your panel. These are adjustable to the brackets on the back, knobs on the back. It's got a bracket for attaching to your tripod. These pieces here will rotate and fold up so you have a fairly small piece to carry. The panel or palette has a cover on it like this. It slides off. And like the day tripper, it also supports itself by gravity on the two front tripod legs with these brackets. It also has a value scale underneath the plexiglass, and some people find that helpful. So there you have it, a brief survey of boxes. Many to choose from, and I didn't even cover the French easels and the other field easels that I have. I'll save that for another video next time. Thanks for watching.